fuck ain't catch. Send him to the bench, I done lost wrong respect. I'm gone down, ready to sit here. Don't hit too low, no, I need my legs. Coach, we sit him, young dog can't catch. Send him to the bench, I done lost wrong respect. I'm gone.
Downtown between Brush Street and I-375. That's where we're located in the heart of Detroit at Ford Field, which first opened back in 2002. A few short moments ago, these two teams made their way out of the Ford Field tunnels, and the noise level in this place just about off the charts. They are set for football as the Lions get ready to do battle with the Cincinnati Bengals. Three quarters of the NFL season are complete. What lurks in our final month? We're underway in week 14. Taken at the 15, a short kick. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. They'll run for the first time with DeAndre Swift. Only a couple for him there on the game's first play, and it's second down.
Early down stuff's to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
Second down and 8. Back to throw. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
It certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. Now, look, that wasn't a huge gain, but those are the types of carries I think they were missing in their loss last week. They couldn't get him going on the ground.
Did you get the same feeling I did during our meetings, that they kind of regretted that he didn't touch the
Absolutely.
Ball?
Absolutely.
You know, hey, he should have touched him more last week. They weren't going to make that same mistake, and they've taken care of that early.
Right back to Swift again on 2nd down. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a 3rd and 4. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
How about this defense? They came up with a couple of big plays in this sequence, and none better than the one right there, forcing the incompletion and bringing up 4th down.
Here comes the Lions punter now. Back deep, Dede Westbrook. They punted 3 times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. Burrow going to lead up the Bengals here, 1st and 10 at their own 20-yard line. The former second-round pick, this is Joe Mixon. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
3 yards remain for 2nd down. Now it's Burrow. Johnson's got it complete. And some room to work. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A big play that time on the catch and run.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. Decided to hand it off that time on the run-pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Off the play fake. Here's Burrow. And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
From the gun on third down is Burrow, completing it to the right side, Johnson. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. A big play there on the catch and run.
You can feel the effort all the way up here. He tried his best to get there. Didn't quite make it, but down around the 2-3 yard line, gotta love the effort, and especially the big play that gave his offense a great opportunity.
Mixon. Able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the one.
It is definitely hard to find space near the goal line. You always want to have a guy in the game running it who can create his own.
Second and goal from the one. They hand off to their big tight end. And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. A great play there. His second touchdown on the season. And the Bengals are going to take a first quarter lead. Evan McPherson for the extra point. He's got it to make it 7-0 Bengals.
Makes the score Bengals 7, Lions nothing.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. Taken at the 15, a short kick. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, do you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trade expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards. On first down and make it a second and three, second and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
Second and 10. They'll look to throw. He's going to get that to Swift underneath. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. 3 catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
A nickel look now for the Bengals as they try to stop him here on third down. Looking to throw. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. picked up by Jesse Bates. And they'll take over inside the 45 at the 44-yard line.
Well, they didn't exactly show patience there, did they? Just down a score, they come out firing right away and compound things by throwing an interception. They put their defense in a really tough spot.
And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 47. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Part of their struggles last week was getting these negative plays on first and second down. That's something they have to be wary of as this game continues.
On second and 12, Burrow eluding the pressure right.
He'll fire one deep for Westbrook.
And this is caught right Let's along go, the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. A big play that time through the air. 31 yards. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Let's go!
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Burrow going to give this to Mixon. And this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
The second down attempt there knocked down as it leaves the quarterback's hand and it's incomplete.
You got to give some credit there, able to hop up in the air and bat that one away. And that's frustrating for an offensive lineman because the only recourse is when he goes in the air to try and give some type of a pop or a shove, hoping to bring his arm.
All right, rifles one and that's going to be intercepted.
Picked off down at the 2. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Lions touchdown.
Well, it certainly looked to me like he tapped into the quarterback's thought process there. But I'm hearing more and more when I go around the league, defenders sitting in on quarterback meetings trying to learn more about how they think so they can be in the right position to be in the right spot, as he was there to pick that one off and take it all the way back for a touchdown.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And no return here from Westbrook. This will be a touchback. The Bengals drive about to get going. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back
yeah,
in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
On second down, here's Mixon. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
That's pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at him and let your big horse charge up the middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing fancy at all, challenging that defense. And on that go-around, the offense won the challenge. This is intercepted. Picked up by Jordan Whitehead. And he will bring it back. An interception return for the Lions touchdown.
It goes without saying, but say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Extra point by Koo, up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. The Bengals drive about to get going. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your players, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
Second down and 3. And they go play action now. Burrow sliding out of the pocket. And a ball going to be intercepted yet again. Picked by Jeff Okuda. Well, that's 3 picks he's now thrown in this game.
And I know this, the holiday season, because here we are in
December.
Right, it is the season of giving. Maybe for his own sake after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he threw.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
End result of that one, a nice 4-yard gain. So you can use that to set up your play action game. Or you can come right back and continue to run the football, because as an offensive play caller, you're on schedule and feeling pretty good about your next couple of calls.
It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up 3rd down. They'll set up a throw. And this pass broken up. Well, the contact well timed there, and now 4th down. Here comes the Lions punter now, as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. And here comes Westbrook. 51 yards on the punt there. And the Bengals will take over here, 1st and 10. The Bengals drive about to get going. And 3 interceptions in this game. I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number 4 is kind of, oh, you're like, oh man, I can't throw 4. But his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked off around the 41.
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage, but instead he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
They've got good starting field position as they come up here 1st and 10 at the 41-yard line. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Flushed out right. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Many times when a play breaks down and the quarterback's moving around outside of the pocket, you're thinking, just get rid of something short. But a lot of guys are coached, think deep, take the big shot, hoping someone can get lost behind the secondary. They weren't able to connect on that one.
And 2nd and 10, he'll look to throw again. He's going to let this one go deep. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's 3rd down.
Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on 1st and 2nd down, bring up 3rd and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure, or do they play coverage on this down?
On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. And that is incomplete.
Certainly looked like someone was very confident in his ability to fit that one in. I would say he was overconfident, because there wasn't a whole lot of separation there. Had that one covered pretty well downfield and knocked it away.
And the punter Bailey on now as he sends this one away. And that'll skip out of bounds inside the 20 at the 17-yard line. The Bengals drive about to get going. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want
want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Second and seven.
We've hit the 2-minute mark of the second quarter. 14-7. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
They will throw on first down, and under the Lions' pressure, he's brought down. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Another try after the first down sack. Burrow. He will find his man Chase complete. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. And the Lions going with an extra DB here on third down. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. Two. Now Burrow. Got this complete to Racy McMath. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on third and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. In need of only about the length of the football here on second down. Throwing again, it's Burrow. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Now the Bengals going to signal for their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. So that'll leave Burrow and the Bengals with a third and long after that sack we just saw. They'll set up to throw. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds, so a big call there that brings up fourth. The Bengals bring out their punter now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. Only two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin him back. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And with 10 seconds left, not really enough time to put something together. And defensively, they're just looking to keep him contained as they're able to get him down. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. They'll throw now on the final play. And he'll air the this one deep for Anderson.
And this a leaping effort, but it's knocked away and incomplete.
So we've reached halftime here in Detroit with the Lions out on top. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. The Bucs set to get the football first, and they trail here as we get started in the second half. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. The Bengals drive about to get going. And they're on the short end of the scoreboard here. Charles, what adjustments, if any, do you think they need to make for the second half?
Well, paraphrasing the gold medal hockey winning coach Herb Brooks, I just say you continue to play your game. Throw the ball. They had success doing it in the first half. So make sure you keep getting the ball to your playmakers, a little bit more to the perimeter perhaps. But above all, play your game.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. And that one going to come up short, low throw. So, Charles, you talk about this head coach and his future with this franchise. Look, it's been a frustrating year, and I think we saw some of that frustration boil over at his weekly press conference earlier in the week.
Yeah, he's trying to say all the right things, isn't he? But he's heard the rumors. He knows what's going on out there. And right now, he is tired of having to answer the question, are you on the hot seat in every meeting with reporters? This week, he kind of said, I've had enough. And I don't blame him. He looks like a guy that may very well be out the door.
Now the throw on third down, knocked away and incomplete.
You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And the Lions will take over. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Open man, he's got him, the tight end, Hockenson. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Here's second and 9. On the handoff, this is Swift. Trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation. They're going to look to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
On 1st and 10, it's Swift. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44.
The defensive coordinators love that. You got a cornerback willing to stick his nose in there, come up on run support, and stop that pop pass dead in its tracks.
And, partner, one good thing about trying to defend that play, you should see it coming the whole way. You see the receiver coming in motion in your direction. Nice job eluding the blocker, making the play behind the line of scrimmage, and even better job steadying the play before you have to try and defend it in the game.
Oh, this will be incomplete. The rush gets home just as he was letting that go. That could have been worse. Instead, it's fourth down.
Here comes the Lions punter now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. He'll get off a fairly short kick here as this is toward the sideline.
That's it, right?
At their own 18-yard line.
The Bengals drive about to get going. The last couple of drives have ended in punts. Maybe the crowd minds that, but you're a defensive guy. You're okay with a couple of punt drives.
Listen, I'm the guy that loves a 0-0 pitch game, all right, in baseball. I can handle that going into the seventh inning. I think the crowd, though, they want to see a little bit more excitement. Let's see if someone can break something free on offense and get going.
Offense at a premium the last two drives.
Back to Mixon on second down.
And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
You know, if following up on this head coach and the pressure that he is under, CD, I want to switch it to you because you've been on winning teams, but I know you've been in similar situations too where things just are not going well. How do you approach that as a player?
It's a tough approach, Brandon, because you actually have to do the opposite of what you would think. You know, in your mind, you're thinking, I redouble my efforts, I go harder. In a sense, you have to back off a little bit. You have to do a little bit less. Do what you're supposed to do, but don't take on the pressures of doing more and trying to do your teammates' jobs as well. If you do that, that's really going to lead you to more issues.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. This will be fielded at the 17. A good return there, 17 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you content to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
First down, and they go with Swift again.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there, second down. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe it'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. On the option to give to Swift here.
And no room that time, getting it to about the 46. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with third and 9 looming.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
On third down, here comes Swift.
Powers through it, and they'll get this across the midfield stripe, but still winding up short of the first down. That'll be good for 6, but now it's fourth down.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
So they're going to come to the line here, and it appears trying to go for it on fourth. So that'll back him up five. Here comes the Lions punter now, as he's on for the fifth time here today. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And they'll let this one go right on the outskirts of the 10. They'll down it at the 11-yard line.
At their own 11-yard line.
Burrow and the Bengals with a first and 10 at their own 11. Try to get the run game going. This is Mixon. And he'll get this one up to about his 14. Antoine Winfield up from the secondary with a tackle. We have played three quarters. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now at Ford Field. It's the Bengals. They've got the football, but they trail here as we get rolling in quarter number four. Throwing on second and 8, Burrow. And my goodness, another interception. Picked up by Jordan Whitehead. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. They'll run on first down. Swift. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about the top plays that these guys like to run. The best runs for the top running back. Those are the ones you focus on and want to take away, and they've done that pretty successfully in this game.
They'll fight forward for a couple down inside the 40. And the trend continues here in the fourth like it was in the first, second, and third. He's had nowhere to run.
And you're probably thinking to yourself, why do they keep feeding him the football? Well, they trust him first and foremost. They do believe that over time he might actually pop one of these runs. But bottom line is, he takes care of the ball well for them, so they'll keep handing it to him.
Now back to throw. And that will be incomplete.
That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a two-score game. And his kick is good. He got every bit of that one as it's good from 56 yards out. So that's, CD, an important one here in the fourth quarter.
And that importance cannot be overstated. All eyes on both sidelines were staring that one down all the way. The significance is that they made it a two-score game. Still lots of time left to go, but likely that was their goal at the start of the drive. Get 3 points, make it a two-score game, and they were able to get it done.
The Bengals drive about to get going. And the complexion of this one has changed a fair amount. That last field goal made it a two-score game, so they need to get points out of this drive relatively quickly. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
There's no question that coming into this game, this defense was pretty vocal about his desire to take this running back out of his game. And all that pregame wolfing has turned into results.
There
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Burrow on play action. And oh, he took that in one-handed. What a grab. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
A bit of an opening there on the first down run as they get this forward for about 6 yards.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Burrow gonna fake to mix it and now look to throw. That's caught by McMahon.
That's a gain of 4 as we slip inside of 4 minutes left in regulation. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
Here we go. It's Burrow on fourth down. And a catch made by Johnson. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Felt compelled to go for it there on fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They got it done.
And there's always a lot of pressure on a fourth down call. Doesn't matter the distance. You stop to get it done, as you noted, and they did.
He'll take a shot for the end zone. He's got it. Touchdown, Bengals.
Racy McMath,
his fifth touchdown now on the year.
And the Bengals have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. McPherson on for the point after.
And this is up and good to make it a 17-14 game.
The score, Lions 17, Bengals 14. Evan McPherson.
So after the made field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You've got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have 3 timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit. And you tell them, here's the situation. They've got all their timeouts. So we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it 3 times and punt it, you got another thing coming.
Yeah, and by the way, also the 2-minute warning in play. So essentially 4 timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive here.
On second down, Swift. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down.
Brings up third down.
They don't want it, fellas.
They'll drop to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Anderson. And he's going to have a Lions first down as he's able to get 8 yards there on 3rd and 5. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. Right back to Swift again on second down. Now the Bengals going to signal for their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
Brings up third and 4.
They'll look to throw here.
And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
Here comes the Lions punter now, as they're forced to kick for the 6th time today. And that is very well done there, as this will be marked out of bounds at the 5-yard line.
You hate to give the ball away here in the 4th quarter while you're just holding a slim lead, but that punt, absolutely ideal. They pin them inside the 5-yard line. They give their defense a really nice opportunity.
The Bengals drive about to get going. They were good last time out with a touchdown drive. This go around, it's not going to be very easy starting from inside their own 5.
But they shouldn't be daunted by it. You work on this the entire offseason. You work on it in practice. It's called coming out session.
And now here's another interception. Picked off at the 15. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Lions touchdown. And so much for the game-winning 2-minute drive. I think that interception return there pretty much seals the deal.
And one thing to keep in mind, in this situation with the score that close.
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Okay, they went for the fake off of the extra point attempt. It's a long way to go, and they didn't get there. Didn't get it completed successfully. Did someone dare them to do that? Did someone double-dog dare him to do that?
Maybe they saw something on film, but do you see something on film with those to try something from the 15 on a PAT? I don't know.
The only thing they needed to see on film there was a snap, a hold, and someone kicking the ball through the post.
The Bengals drive about to get going. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yep, 2-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again.
And the Lions pressure too strong. Down he goes. Aleem McNeil in there to take him down and the clock will roll. Here's Burrow. He's going to let it fly. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be 3rd down. Trying to go for the big one there on 2nd down. Now they're likely down to their final 2 plays.
And you know they've got to keep going for the big shot, right? So defensively, you play what they call top down. Nothing behind you. Make everything get completed in front.
Burrow. He'll buy some time right. And he's going to be taken down. Sacked back at the 2. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. The Bengals bring out their punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he'll try and hurry the kick, gets it away, but it's not looking that great. Only 29 yards on the punt there, definitely not his best. And the Lions will have excellent field position here as they take over 1st and 10. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Here's a handoff to Swift. And a solid run down inside the 30. 48 yards on the ground for him so far. I guess the simple question, why not just take a knee there?
I don't understand either why you would take any sort of a chance. We've seen it happen in the game of football. Doesn't matter whether you've watched high school, college, or the NFL. Some people get a little greedy, try to get that extra running play in, and it can backfire on them.
Oh, now look at this. They're lining up to add three more, a little insult to injury here late in the game. Made his first. This now from 46 yards away. And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. And that will give them a 12-point lead. So they settle for just the three. But clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the fourth.
Without a doubt. Obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off. But it's still eight up time. Got points. So while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
Just hit the field goal. Now he kicks off. And no return here from Westbrook. This will be a touchback. Drive about to get going. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
Whistles and a flag, and I believe a Bengal got going a little early there. And now we're going to get a timeout. Somewhat pointlessly called with 3 seconds to go in a game that's already been decided. A full start backs him up five, first and 15. A final shot now for Burrow. And that one off the mark behind him, incomplete. So this one's over. It's a win for the Detroit Lions, and they've got to feel good about this performance. I think you'd agree, matched up against a top five defensive unit in the league, and they pretty much had their way.
Yeah, that was the interesting part about it, because normally when we see this defense play, they have their opportunities, and they make their plays, don't they? They knock them back on their heels. They take the ball away. They change field position. In this case, what you said is so apt. They had their way with them, took it to them, and knocked them back on their heels and surprised the heck out of them.
So for the Lions, it's a fourth win on the year as they move to 4-9. And they will hit the road next week for a date with the New Orleans Saints. Meanwhile, for Cincinnati, it's going to all but eliminate them from the playoff picture as they fall to 5-8. And they'll try to rebound next week as they head to Heinz Field to take on the Steelers.